Okay, we're going to have a few questions here. I think there are certain people. Yeah, if you have some questions, I think that'll be really nice. Okay, we have a girl over there. So can I have your name, please?
My name is Swati Batra Jain. Okay. And my question is, how do you pick up stars for your calendar? Like, I mean, everybody is good, and I'm sure you don't want to be controversial. How do you do it?
So do you pick them up, or it's a, or they call you up, and how does it work?
I basically, out of these so many years, I think about 18 to 20 have been constants who I work a lot with anyway. Okay. So like I said, Ash was there, Mr. Bachchan, Hrithik, Abhishek, Arjun, many of them who I've been shooting a lot through my career, Hrithik, have been a part of most of my calendars.
Gee.
And then there are only variables of three or four which keep changing depending if I'm adding one or two newcomers, if I'm just to add some fresh list, freshness. And then I make a wish list of my 24. Then what happens is somebody's traveling, somebody's in a particular look, they can't shoot, someone's you know, feeling fat, they don't want to shoot. So
somebody feels fat and they say, we don't want to shoot?
We'll okay. do it next year.
Okay, I'm feeling thin. Can I shoot with you today? How many? I'm sure all the girls are feeling thin tonight. All the girls, you're feeling... Sorry?
Girls never feel thin.
Yeah. She's feeling fat, but she still wants to shoot with you.
Girls never feel thin.
Absolutely. Yeah, girls never feel thin. Also. Okay, next question. Anybody else? There we are. Yes, ma'am. Aap to teacher hain. Achha, koi baat nahi. Boliye.
Hi, and my name is Smriti. I just want to ask one thing. Going with the caption of this session, I just want to ask one thing. What actually Dabu Ratnani camera loves? Like, see, fashion concept, what?
What does Dabu Ratnani's camera love? Sees through the lens. That's what she wants to know.
Yeah, I honestly, you know, categorize myself as a people photographer. It need not be a celebrity. It could be just people. Like some of the shots that I saw even out there, they inspire me. I feel, you know, like those locations. It's difficult to get actors to such locations, you know. But I've shot with many models and fashion campaigns in Jaisalmer, in Jodhpur, in Jaipur, Udaipur. So I love location shoots. To be honest, if you ask me my preference, my USP is location shoots. I love shooting outdoor. I love shooting with natural light. The way I feel I can mold natural light and the way I can use backgrounds and lighting outdoors without any trying to be like arrogant, I think many people cannot handle it the way I shoot people outdoor. It's kind of my where I started my career, because in the first 4 years I couldn't afford a studio. I started from a very basic camera, then I invested into a better camera, then I invested, bought more lenses, then buying a studio was like buying lights was too expensive.
Yeah, and you need to understand Bombay is not an easy city to be in. It's I think rated among the top three most expensive cities in the world. So to stay in Bombay and to buy a studio and the cameras and the all the stuff that he's talking about, this is really expensive.
Expensive
stuff.
And secondly, back then, 25 years ago, photography was not a career option like it is today.
True.
You know, those days, photography was a very niche profession. You know, there were the times of doctors, engineers, you know, the big careers who were like given importance to. So there was no photography institutes in India. So today, if you had to do photography, a course, you had to go to Santa Barbara or to New York or to London, which I couldn't afford.
Right.
So I started shooting a lot outdoor. I started shooting with people outdoor. And even in the first few years of my career, I used to go to actors' homes and shoot them in their house with natural light, or I used to take them below their building and shoot. You know, I say. So in fact, they liked that because they, first of all, were very comfortable picking out something from their wardrobe and wearing it and walking down. And also, they were so used to studio shoots that, you know, they were so used to that typical hair light and those big hairdos and those,
wigs and everything.
And fabrics tying on their hair. And
right, right.
In the 80s, that for them, being themselves was being, it was a change for them. So I started shooting them like models.
But there used to be these amazing shoots jo 80s, 70s mein hote
the,
where you had all these एक्टर्स सेकंड लेवल ए बी सी और वो ग्रेडिंग के हिसाब से होता था. तो जो सी और डी ग्रेड के एक्टर्स थे यू नो वो टावल पहन के घूमते रहते थे. एंड दैट्स व्हाट द शूट यू एंड यू हैड दिस अमेजिंग पोजेस ऑफ स्टफ लाइक दिस एंड स्टफ लाइक दिस एब्सोल्युटली क्रेजी स्टफ ऑल ओवर. जी एनी अदर क्वेश्चन? यस वी हैव ओवर हियर वन हियर योर नेम प्लीज.
What problem are you talking about? What problem? Give me an example.
Like you know, there are a lot of lighting issues sometimes. So the cameraman is not able to fix it up or he is not able to take the frame correctly.
Right.
So framing is very important part if you are shooting something.
Right.
So how can we guide him or you know, there are some tips or how can we in front of the camera be a little more creative?
What kind of a problem are you talking? What problem? Give me an example like what you...
Like you know there are a lot of lighting issues sometimes. So the cameraman is not able to fix it up or he is not able to take the frame correctly.
Right.
So framing is very important part if you are shooting something.
Right.
So how can we guide him or you know there are some tips or how can we in front of the camera be a little more creative?
One straight tip I'll give you whether you're shooting from your phone or you're shooting with a professional camera, try and shoot in open shade. Don't try and shoot in direct sunlight if it's an odd hour of the day. You know, when you're shooting, try and stay in a shaded area. If it's daylight coming from outside, it's fine. But to handle direct sunlight, you need to have reflectors, you need to have a bounce light, various other things. Maybe the photographer didn't have it at that point. Or if you shoot in direct sunlight, either it has to be in the first 1.5 hours of the morning, which sunrise, or 1.5 hours in the evening, you know, where it's you can handle the direct sunlight, like 5 to 6 in the evening, or like 6 to 7 in the morning. That's where you can shoot in direct sunlight. Otherwise, you need molding to be done, you need reflectors, you need various equipment. Best bet is to shoot in shade, you know, open shade. You'll get soft pictures, it won't look harsh, your hair look nice, the skin will look nice. That's one straight off tip I can give you to start.
Or the other thing is you could just call up Dabu and say, can you shoot for me? Yeah. Yeah, phir jaise unhone bola open shade hai chhatri leke ghumo.
But it's true. If you can even, if it's a close up and you just hold a white umbrella or a umbrella, you can, or a neutral color umbrella, you can.
I think that's exactly, of course, aapki bhi wo thermocol jo sabse zyada istemal hota hai. Hum bhi log jab shoot karte hain, and the light peeche bahut hard hoti hai and you need light on the face, so the thermocol is right here aur wo itna chamak raha hota hai ki you know we can't open our eyes. But as actors it's a very difficult job ki you have something that is flashing into your eyes and you need to give all the emotions with your lines and everything put together, so it's not an easy job, but that's how it's done. Next question please. Okay, one over there. लाइफ में कभी सेटिस्फैक्शन होती नहीं है किसी भी चीज़ को लेके. ये सवाल यहाँ जितने हैं सबकी यही प्रॉब्लम है. मुझे पूछेंगे मेरी भी यही प्रॉब्लम है. आई एम स्टिल नॉट सेटिस्फाइड. जी डब्बू.
सो नाउ डेज यू नो व्हाट पीपल व्हाट सेलिब्रिटीज हैव स्टार्टेड डूइंग यू मस्ट हैव सीन ऑन इंस्टाग्राम इज दैट व्हेन दे वेयर एन आउटफिट ऑफ अ डिजाइनर दे एक्चुअली हायर अ फोटोग्राफर फॉर दोज 15 मिनट्स बिफोर दे स्टेप आउट फॉर एन इवेंट. सो दे विल डू अ प्रॉपर लाइटिंग सेटअप. And you know it's an investment. Today if you're not happy with, you probably should connect with a photographer, you know, take that you know expense in your stride. And because if you're going to do a great outfit, you want justice, you want it to be shot well, so you should invest and connect with a photographer who will probably wants to build his portfolio. There are a lot of photographers on Instagram who will do it for free as well, or will charge you a very minimal amount so that they are building their page as well, you know. So I feel a tie-up, like many people I meet in Bombay, at my gym, various places, models, they connect with like young photographers, young designers, young, they collaborate and do like a shoot just for Instagram, you know, and promote themselves. So one is promoting the other. So maybe a tie-up with that with a with a photographer would help you. Yeah.
And when he's talking about connecting with a photographer, you know what he's talking about. Don't connect in any other level. The level it's supposed to be connected. Anyway, next question. There we are.
There are new photographers, like a lot of people trying out their hands in photography now, especially fashion or influencers, etc. So how do they sustain their lifestyle? Because it's so expensive, as we just talked about it, you know, the lenses, this, that, everything, setting up a studio, or even, you know, from Jaipur going out there in Mumbai is quite expensive. And nowadays, every good model is asking for, you know, free shoot. A good designer will say, okay, then you do a couple of shoots for me, we'll see. So how do they sustain in this industry?
See, it's about, first of all, making a mark in the industry. Today, when I started out, there were not even rental companies for cameras. Today, I can be owning zero equipment and rent everything for the shoot. So I'm not those, I mean, I must have put in obscene amount of money in equipment and my, you know, my gear over the years, because you have to keep updating your equipment. So today,
on an average, how much do you end up putting into your equipment every year? On an average,
even now, I'd say even now, like 25 lakhs a year.
25 lakhs every year,
if not more,
to upgrade the equipment that you have.
Yeah. So there's an initial investment which today's photographers don't do, don't need to do,
because sab rental pe milta hai. Everything is on rent.
So should the photographers say no to free shoots as well, like nowadays?
See, at least you can pick up the cost of hiring. Today, a photographer, if he wants to build his portfolio, I did that in my career to start with. You know, I used to shoot portfolios for free. So they used to pay for the roll, processing and printing. I did my first feature film, which was Aatish, in 1993, where I went to Mauritius for a photo shoot with Sanjay Dutt and the whole, for 30 days. I did it for the pure experience. Vijay Sippy, who was the producer, picked up the cost of my travel, food and roll processing and printing. That's it. But what I gained from those 30 days was immense. My career got set up in those 30 days. So you have to make the right decisions on what you have to shoot. You have to connect with the right people. You know, you have to be out there. Things don't come to you on a platter. You have to push yourself, you know, to go up there.
And honestly speaking, the career that we're talking about, you know, we're talking about being a radio jockey or a photographer or an actor or a dancer or a singer. These are careers jo kaise bane hain, kiske bane hain. There are no hard and fast rules. This is not a career in the army where at the age of 18, you join the NDA, you do a 3-year course, 1 year in the CDS, and then you come out as a second lieutenant at the age of 21. So there are no rules and regulations. It's up to you how you want to work around people,
absolutely,
how you blend in with people and how things work for you. So yahan pe kuch, honestly, hamari industry mein kuch nahi chalta hai. Kaise career ban jata hai?
Yeah, there's no formula to it.
No formula. Oh, fine arts mein there is no formula. Any other question, please? Okay, there's one gentleman over there. Ji.
I want to ask, is it necessary to put your logo or signature on the photographs?
It's optional. It's not necessary. Some people say that when you put a logo or you put a watermark, the pictures don't travel as much on Instagram. I don't know how true that is. But when people, like, I put my logo. I do put my logo. And sometimes I watermark the pictures because, you know, they get picked up by various other portals and other stuff like that. So I like to put it. But some actor told me that when you put a logo or a watermark, that it does not, the reach is much lesser because the algorithms of Instagram think you're using a brand. So maybe initially you don't need to, but it's totally a personal call, to be very honest.
आपने कुछ लोगों सोचा अपने बारे में सोचा है क्या है कुछ रजत थर्ड आई
अच्छा
रचित थर्ड आई शिव के बहुत करीब हैं आप बैठिए ओके जी
हाय
he wants to be the second Dabu Ratnani and he's saying he wants some tips. जी सबसे पहले तो आप
दिस सेशन इज टू शॉर्ट टू गिव मी सो मेनी टिप्स बट ये सब बेसिकली इज वेरी ऑनेस्टली यू नो जिस तरह से मैंने अपना करियर शेप किया है I've not done an, I didn't go to an institute. So everybody's career is shaped up differently. You know, I say, 25 साल पहले इतना plan नहीं किया था, 20 साल पहले plan नहीं किया था ये calendar इतना लंबा चलेगा. So it's, like I said, it's very instinctive. You have to make decisions, you have to...
And I honestly believe the best careers which have lasted for a long time have been careers जो आदमी काम करते करते सीखते सीखते आगे बढ़ा है.
And basically that fire should be there. Yeah. That कुछ हर आज आप shoot कर रहे हो, कुछ एक चीज नया करना चाहिए. You know, comfort zone से बाहर जाके कुछ नया, कुछ एक नया lens ले लिया या कुछ lens rent पे ले लिया या कुछ एक light rent पे ले लिया. I feel आज भी, you know, like even like the shoot I was doing yesterday also. मुझे लगता है मैंने कुछ नया किया है उसमें जो मैंने पहले नहीं किया. So even my attitude now also is that I should try something different. जिस तरह से मैं I think हर photographer को कुछ काम अपने लिए करना चाहिए. You know, it's not only doing commercial work through the year. पूरा साल हम commercial काम करते हैं, but at least साल में 10-12 shoot खुद के लिए करने चाहिए.
True, and I think this goes for every artist, whether he's a singer or a dancer or of any kind. There's a lot of stuff that you need to do for your own creative existence.
It's true.
For your own creativity, if you want to get a little better. Otherwise, हमारी लाइन में बोलते हैं ना भाई पैसों के लिए हम बहुत काम करते हैं जो हम करते भी हैं बट एट द सेम टाइम क्रिएटिवली फॉर योर ओन सेटिस्फैक्शन देयर इज अ लॉट दैट यू नीड टू डू एनीवे डबू थैंक यू सो मच
इट्स
बीन सच अ प्रेजर यू हैव कम ऑल द वे फ्रॉम मुंबई
थैंक यू
एंड आई एम श्योर एवरीबॉडी आउट हियर इज थैंकफुल टू यू आई थिंक एंड आई थिंक जोरदार तालियां फॉर डबू रतनानी कम ऑन गाइस गेट योर हैंड्स टुगेदर